Okay, so
you're going to turn this into a show, maybe, huh?
Indeed. In fact, I just started my recorder, so everything that you say from now on
will be used against you in
a court of public opinion.
Oh, in a court of public opinion.
Yeah,
that may be worse.
So we're rolling. Be careful.
Okay.
We still got like 4 minutes to go, right?
Yeah. Yeah.
Spreaker turn itself on. Is that the way that works?
No. I hit the button. I just typed in all the info, and then I hit the go live button, and then it goes, but it will turn off promptly at the end of 45 minutes.
A hard out.
Yeah, it gives me a countdown, but after 45 minutes, it goes away. But the nice thing about Spreaker is it's all set up. It's linked to Facebook. It's linked to Twitter. It's linked to SoundCloud. It's linked to YouTube. And so as soon as the show ends, everything is posted.
But the only place to listen live is actually on the Spreaker site.
Spreaker, yes.
Which is findable on your website.
Right. Which all I did was get a domain and point it to the Spreaker page. So
yeah,
I may at some point add a real web page. But
yep. Because I found you on TuneIn. I found you on TuneIn Radio.
Yeah.
But I was half expecting to get the live feed there, and it wasn't. So last week I had to scramble and I missed the beginning of the conversation, which I went back and picked up.
Yeah. Yeah, that's the one that lags. This creates an RSS feed,
mm-hmm.
That feeds iTunes and all that kind of thing. And so on TuneIn, I had to go in on TuneIn and tell it to, you know, pick up the RSS feed where all the other Spreaker shoots it out. So it takes a few hours before TuneIn picks it up.
So every place else in the world is better than what I'm using.
I don't know about that, but I like TuneIn. I use TuneIn a lot,
yeah.
But the app. But yeah, that one does take a while to update.
I realized I didn't zero my watch here. It's maybe 30 seconds off. I can tune in WWV if that'll help.
Oh, yeah. All the time.
We now pause for the time. We'll take a little time for the time. After this timeout.
I found that clip. It was just, I got to use that.
It was good.
Yeah.
I got to realize that you're not watching my video, so you're not going to see the stuff that I put up here.
Yeah, it's kind of like this one email I got that the guy wanted to talk about a PVC antenna on the show. I'm like, it's radio. Well, I said, I'm trying to figure out how we can do this on radio. And he's like, well, I got some pictures I can send you. And I'm like, yeah, that doesn't help on radio.
You paint an oral picture.
Yeah, exactly. Of a PVC antenna.
Well, I get as many people doing ham radio now on audio download as watch it on video. I don't think real hard about making sure everything's going to work for audio, but I should.
Yeah. Yeah. All right. I'm going to hit the button here and do the little music thing, and here we go.
It's ham radio.
Good evening, everyone. This is Ham Talk Live, episode number 3. Gary Pierce, KN4AQ, recorded live on Thursday, March 3rd, 2016. And I'm your host, Neil Rapp, WB9VPG. Thanks for tuning in to this episode of Ham Talk Live. Tonight on the show, Gary Pierce, KN4AQ, will join us. Gary will talk about his wildly successful video podcast, Ham Radio Now. And during the last part of the show, we will, as always, be taking your calls live. Last week on the big show, Don Wilbanks, AE5DW, was our guest, and Don and I really had a blast, and we will do it again soon to talk about the Young Ham of the Year Award once that nominating period begins, so we'll have that coming up soon. And if you missed that show or any future show, you can listen to the replay on hamtalklive.com, or you can pick that up on Spreaker, TuneIn, iTunes, SoundCloud, or YouTube. Well, here we are at episode number 3, and I'm learning some things and relearning some things from my audio past. So I'm trying to make a few adjustments to the show, and one of the adjustments we're going to make tonight is make sure we have time for live calls, because that's kind of the main goal of the show, and last week we did not hit that at all. So be ready to call in. We're going to take calls a little earlier this evening. So in just a few minutes, be ready. You can Skype us at Ham Talk Live. That's the username, Ham Talk Live. Or by telephone, the number is 812-NET-HAM-1. That's 812-638-4261. And we're trying out a new call system tonight in hopes we can improve some in that area. So I'd like to thank Nick Bauer, KC9GZY, for handling the Skype switchboard and the social media duties tonight during the show and in weeks to come. And I'll try not to call him Snerdly too often. So tonight, Gary Pierce is my guest from Ham Radio Now. Gary grew up in Chicago and is now in the Raleigh, North Carolina area. And 4 years ago, he started the show Ham Radio Now. So Gary, welcome to Ham Talk Live.
Neil, it is 9 o'clock on the East Coast. Normally at this time of night, I would be sitting on the couch with my wife next to me, a cat on my lap, probably another cat sitting on my arm, a mug of hot chocolate perched precariously on the arm of the sofa. And we would be watching, well, these days, probably Scandal. So this had better be worth it.
So yeah, it better be worth it. And you know, it could be one of those, anything can happen Thursdays you were talking about.
Yeah.
But we won't go with the vegetables tonight. we won't go there, but maybe we can get a bazinga or two in there. So I should admit this, that one of the reasons for the time slot, although it's not a major reason for the time slot, but one of the reasons that it's at the time that it is so that it doesn't interfere with Big Bang Theory.
So you need a DVR.
That actually was one thing, but yeah, that's what I do. I DVR it. In fact, I haven't actually watched it. I need to catch up on it, but,
yeah, I'm a cord cutter, so I don't watch anything live.
That's one of the many reasons that this fit in. Yeah, I find that I do that more and more. You know, it's two hit button.
Yeah, we're heading rapidly out of sync here. You're lagging on me like crazy. So hopefully it'll catch up.
Okay. Yeah, you're coming back. Yeah, you're coming back.
Okay.
I think we're good there.
Yay, Skype.
Okay. Well, like I said, we're trying out the new Skype thing, so we'll see how that goes. So anyway, tell us about Ham Radio Now. Tell us how that started and what your goals are with the show.
Well, I was hoping you would ask me that question. But the actual start of Ham Radio Now began in 1970, and this is what it sounded like.
A service of ABC News.
This is the sound of wonderful music. WBOR-FM.
Good evening. My name is Gary Pierce, and we are here with the Thursday Night Radio program from WDOR-FM. I'd like to warn you right off first that I think I'm catching whatever's going around, so a warning, stay away from your radio, don't get too close, and by all means, don't touch the dial. That could seriously cause you to catch what I might have. Peggy Lee. I think she's caught what I might have.
I like your brother.
Yeah, okay, so that was the beginning, 1970. WDOR, Sturgeon Bay, Wisconsin, when I was actually a real broadcaster because I drew a paycheck, so I wasn't totally a wannabe, but boy, was I a wannabe. And I just, you know, I'd fallen in love with broadcast radio as well as ham radio throughout my teens and really wanted to be on the air someplace. And once I got there, I realized I had a problem. I didn't have anything to say. So I worked on that for a while. So tell you what,
yeah, you have to kind of fix that.
Yeah, let me, and did that one sound okay? Did I get the mix minus
right? Yeah, that sounded great.
Okay, good. So advance the story to 1988, and my next attempt, most of my career has been in video editing. So, you know, I wanted to be in radio, but I couldn't really get work because you could tell how good I was. And so I did video editing for about 12 years, and then I had to try radio one more time. So here's the one more time.
For all the facts, call this station and say,
I saw it on the radio. I saw it on the radio.
Good time to tell you that KFWJ is rated number one. Arbitron has just completed the Mojave County Listener Survey. KFWJ rated number one in all of Mojave County, the most listened to of all AM and FM stations, both sides of the Colorado River, from Blythe to Lake Mead. How about that? Number one, thanks to you, our listeners.
KFWJ, KBBC, Lake Havasu City, the American home for the London Bridge.
Start spreading the news.
7 o'clock.
So, I got better. I'm not sure when my voice changed, but I was 38 years old then, and clearly my voice changed sometime after that.
You just brought back some real memories because I remember the I saw it on the radio campaign.
Yeah. Yeah.
There were a lot of radio stations that used that to sell advertising.
Yep. The National
Which, of course, is the number one thing in radio.
Yeah. Yeah, some radio. Yeah. And it was an NAB promotion. So that was cool. So I got better without any practice in between. Somehow got better. But still, you know, radio. That job lasted 3 months. I got fired for talking too much about the wrong things, and I went back to video editing for another dozen years or so. So let me advance the story to this television stuff here. You had said that ham radio now started 4 years ago, which it did, but its predecessor, the first video thing that I did, actually started 11 years ago in 2004, called Amateur Radio Video News, and I made some programs and sold DVDs. Not very fast, not very prolifically, but I made a few. The reason I started that was in 2003. This space shuttle Columbia had disintegrated on reentry and left pieces of itself all over East Texas. And I wanted to go there and shoot video really bad. I didn't have good equipment. I had Hi-8 camera and stuff. And I really wanted to go there and shoot video of it. I couldn't get away. I was freelancing at the time and I had lots of work and I couldn't quite get away, but I really wanted to do that. And the reason why I really wanted to do that is our media sucks. We're terrible at it. Bill Pasternak and I have commiserated a lot about how badly we do media. It's really hard to get still pictures of hams doing important things, especially in the emergency communications and the public safety arena. We don't get really good pictures of hams doing that. We get no video at all. And Bill tried to start something called the Ham Radio Video Corps and encourage hams to acquire and then maybe edit video of us doing stuff. Went nowhere. We're still doing none of that. Katrina came and went. Almost nothing. One guy went in there with a camera and shot some stuff, but that never became a program. It became a short blurb that the league did. So we're terrible at it. So I really wanted to, and I got started in 2004, video equipment was starting to get affordable enough. Not, I wouldn't call it cheap, but I could buy a good camera for about $4,500. Makes really good pictures. And I did that. And the first story I thought I might go do was the W3AO field day operation. I had been noticing that those guys did something unusual. They had a 50A, 51A field day operation. And we worked them from the field day I was at. And I was always thinking, that can't be right. Don't know how they do that.
Exactly.
It's got to be a scam of some kind. So I noticed that they were lined up to do another 50A, and I called the guys and said, can I come up here? And like, I'm starting this ham radio television show. Can I come up there and document it? And they said, yeah, sure. Why not? So I did. And although I shot it in 2004, I finally released the DVD in 2011. So you can tell how fast I am at turning things around. So, but that was the beginning.
You make time.
Yeah. Editing is slow. Well, I released several others in between. I did a documentary on ARDF direction finding because it was, their national championships were just down the road from me, local. And they wanted to get those out so people could see it. So I shot that in, I think in 2008 and released it only a few months later. And a couple of other things. I did a documentary called Digital Voice for Amateur Radio. And I shot that, a lot of it in 2008. And then got it released within a few months. So a lot of work there. And then I finally got around to doing that field day thing. I shot the 10th anniversary of the W3AO operation, in 2014, and I still haven't edited that. So I haven't lost my old ways entirely, but sort of.
I know what you mean. I've got a project at school that we shot all the video and did everything, and then it's still sitting.
Yeah,
I totally get that.
So podcasting, the concept of podcasting in online stuff actually began about 2004 when I was taking a major step into the late 1990s and doing DVDs. The people who understood what was going on, you know, Leo Laporte, even George Thomas in Amateur Logic, not Ham Nation yet, but Amateur Logic. He started back then. So yeah. Guys were getting this. I just wasn't. I was, you know, old school. And then I got invited to be a guest host on Ham Nation when they started that on Twit in 2011. And I did a bunch of those shows. Bob Heil knew he was going to be on the road a lot. So he was casting about for someone who had some experience, and someone pointed him my way, I guess. Haven't seen the DVDs. And so he asked me if I would do it. And I said, yeah, as long as you don't ask me to fill in full time, because I'd never be able to find time for that. So I did a half a dozen of those shows. And he stopped calling. He just said, he didn't say anything. He stopped calling. And about that point, I decided I really did like doing it and thought I could maybe do it regularly. So I started the Ham Radio Now thing. And he gave me a guest shot. My first Ham Radio Now episodes came from the Orlando Hamcation. I went down there and shot a bunch of interviews and a tour of the place in 2011. And he gave me a good parting shot doing that. And then I just never heard from him again. So I figured he didn't need me. And he went on to Don Wilbanks and a whole bunch of other people. So I've been doing then the Ham Radio Now since then. And we're up at this, by the way, I never introduced the video part of the show. Your radio listeners don't realize we're also making a Ham Radio Now program. So let me introduce it. Ham Radio Now, episode 246. look, I'm on Ham Talk Live. I mean, listen, I'm on Ham Talk Live. So now that I've introduced
my own
show.
But we don't get the sound effects of the lower third flying in.
I do that in post.
We don't get that.
Yeah, I do that in post.
But they'll on the video.
Yeah,
you guys will get it, but our listeners won't.
No, you just get me.
Get the fly in.
So that's
that. So, you know, go ahead.
That's it. That's how we got started, and then I just keep churning them out as fast as I can. I've added. I was doing the Tapper. Digital communications conferences on DVD from 2008 on, and then just folded them into the ham radio now video.
And one of the things that, that you do to keep this going, because like you said, video is not cheap. You know, this show I, you know, put together pretty, you know, not a whole lot of cost, but it's not cheap. So tell us about Arvin.
And I'm on my second generation of equipment because I bought all the video cameras and stuff, in standard definition, 4x3 ratio, just as high definition stuff was starting to hit the market at this level of, production. So, I hung in with standard definition for as long as I could, but I switched to high definition before I started Ham Radio Now. So everything on Ham Radio Now is high def. And once again, a brand new camera to tote down to Orlando. Arvin, the name of Arvin comes from what people were calling the original program. It's Amateur Radio Video News, ARVN. One of the world's most terrible names for a television program. And it also turns out that the initials ARVN stand for the Army of the Republic of Vietnam, which people reminded me of over and over and over again. I'm thinking, well, you know, they're gone and I'm still here, but I eventually changed to Ham Radio Now. But I adapted the Arvin name as the name of the mascot, a little piggy bank sitting back here over my shoulder. Folks on the video can see that. He represents viewer financial contributions. And his name is Arvin, A-R-V-I-N. I've got a little Arvin reel-to-reel portable tape recorder that I got to work into the deal somehow, but I've never played with that. So from the very beginning, I didn't want to line up advertisers. I wanted individual contributions from viewers, and they've been surprisingly good. It hasn't made a living. I would really like for this to be a full-time deal. And it's not even close, but it has averaged, since Ham Radio Now started, about $7,000 to $8,000 a year, plus a few very successful Kickstarters for the Tapper stuff, which brought in $12,000 one year and a little over $8,000 the next. But last year, the Kickstarter didn't work. Goose egg. But people have been contributing individually to the program. I also started a Patreon when that stuff got started, so people can contribute on a ongoing basis through Patreon. So
excellent.
Probably most people doing podcasts would say you're making $10,000 a year off your podcast. You are doing awesome, boy. But like I say, and people always say, well, don't try to monetize your podcast. It's you're going down the wrong road. Do it for fun. But I kind of want this absolutely to be a deal, and it is expensive to do.
Yeah. I'm lucky that my expenses are low, and so I just, you know, do a couple of very inexpensive ads, and that pretty much takes care of it, you know, a few months down the road anyway, it will.
Is it like a dollar a holler? Have you heard that radio expression?
Yeah, it's not quite a dollar a holler, but it's not too far off of that. So,
and by the way, you do them wrong.
That'll go, but.
You do them wrong. What? You do your ads wrong.
Do them wrong?
Yeah.
Oh,
here in the podcast land, the ads are effective when the host does them live, and you produce yours, and almost no podcasters produce their ads. You get that that native advertising feel to them. Cindy, come over here, my lovely wife Cindy. She's come on, get over. She's got no makeup on. Well, this is radio. We're on radio.
It's radio. It doesn't matter. Exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly.
She's wandering through the studio, but she's not. She says she's not going to come in front of the camera. Well, I don't have a microphone for you over there, so holler.
Yes.
Holler. Hi, everybody.
Hello, everybody.
Okay, that's Cindy, KD4ACW.
There we go.
When people do when people do see her on the show, I always get a lot of email that says, how did an ugly old guy like you get a young, beautiful wife like that? And I've got pictures. That's the thing. It's blackmail. I just got lucky.
Now occasionally, The mouse shows up on the show.
Yeah, I'm surprised I don't have a cat. Yeah, Cindy's going to go get me a cat. So, yeah. We have one of the other things that we do is cat rescue. We're big into cat rescue, especially Cindy, but I help her out as much as I can. And we have a feral colony with two cats in it right now because we've been very successful in the trap, neuter, return, or trap, neuter, adopt, where you get feral cats. And if they're young enough, you bring them in and domesticate them and get them adopted at a shelter. So we're pretty good at that. We got three of our own right now. And then in the house, there's two more cats that we are fostering until they're ready for being adopted. So five cats going on. I'm hoping to do a podcast on cat rescue because I've surveyed the market. A lot more people out there into cats than there are into ham radio. And no one's serving that market. Yeah. So I've got the domain rescuecat.tv. And I want to do something with it when I get around to it. Maybe
some Jackson Galaxy. Maybe.
Well, the other thing about it is ham radio media, ham radio online media tops out at about what we're doing here in Twit. Cats, they get real big time TV, on cable and stuff, Jackson Galaxy. So we won't hit that level, but it's, I don't think anyone is talking to the folks that do this animal rescue. Cat rescue. We'll focus on cats. The people will say, why don't you do dogs too? And it's not because we don't like dogs. Just, cats are our thing and we'll talk about dogs.
Yeah. But,
I want to get that ginned up. And now that I've let the world know, I guess I better get to it.
There you go. Well, Allie's been running around here, but since it's radio, you don't hear Allie. So we won't.
They can make
get into
noise.
That. Although Allie did try to get in on Ham Nation, she jumped up on the desk right behind me, and George says, "There's a tail coming out of your head," and I'm like, "Allie, down."
Yeah. Okay.
So she tried, but my favorite cat ham radio video was when I was like probably either 5 or 6 years old, and I'm copying code, and the cat jumps up on top of the HF rig and starts batting around my pencil while I'm trying to copy CW.
They're good at that.
Old home movie of that.
Yep, they're good at that. There's tons of pictures on Facebook of cats sleeping on radios, amplifiers, tube stuff particularly.
It's warm. Oh yeah.
So I don't know. We can get any live calls here. I'm taking over your show.
Speaking of ads, we do need to do one more ad, and I do want to take, since we kind of had to do things abruptly because Skype was being Skype.
Yeah.
I do want to thank Scott and Jill from Tower Electronics, and this is that live thing you're talking about.
Oh, cool.
Because they have sponsored the show for the first few months, and I've used their products in repeater installations and at work and at home, and they've been really supportive over the years with their repeaters and with the school, and they've got great stuff. So give them a call or order at pl-259.com. And right now we're going to listen to a little spot about our other sponsor tonight, and that's the Ham Station. And we'll be back with Gary Pierce, KN4AQ, right after this.
This episode of Ham Talk Live is brought to you by the Ham Station.
Good time to mention that Ham Radio Now is brought to you by you. So if you get something out of the programs, stop by and see Arvin and click the pig. HamRadioNow.tv. And now back to Neil.
The Ham Station, proud to sponsor this episode of Ham Talk Live.
You're listening to Ham Talk Live with Neil Rapp. Hey, baby, what's your sign? What's your call sign?
Welcome back to Ham Talk Live. We also want to mention our logo contest that's wrapping up. If you want to make a logo for the show, send it to logo@hamtalklive.com. Between now and Monday, that's logo@hamtalklive.com. And we're going to announce the winner on next week's show. So be sure to tune in for that. And we do want to thank the Ham Station for sponsoring the show tonight so we can bring you Ham Talk Live. I've been shopping at the Ham Station since the first day they opened 37 years ago. And Dan and Jeff can give you a hand. Give them a call or go to hamstation.com. I'm Neil Rapp, WB9VPG, joined this evening by Gary Pierce, KN4AQ. And if you have a question for Gary, give us a call on Skype. Our username is Ham Talk Live. Or you can join us by telephone at 812-NET-HAM-1. That's 638-4261. Again, area code 812-638-4261. And if the line's busy, try again after we finish up on a caller, and we'll try to get you in here. We have 9 minutes left, so hopefully we can get a couple of calls in this evening since our technical difficulties took away a little time with us. While we're waiting, oh, and there's Allie in the background. I don't think the microphone picked her up. But I recently watched your All Parody All the Time episode. And I had it on YouTube. You were talking about different ways, you know, to catch the show. And I had it on YouTube, but I had it playing through the car. So I had the audio and the video, but I didn't watch the video. I was listening as I was driving. And you had a lot of clips there from the actual subcommittee discussions and everything. And really like how you took that and dug into everything you know, kind of picked that apart. That was very interesting, and it'll be interesting to see where this goes.
It's going way better than I ever expected. Once we hit a Senate version of the bill, I thought, well, there's a chance. Of course, I screwed it up because I thought it was only a 1-year deal, and I thought, you know, at the end of last year, I thought it was dead and had to be restarted, but. I really need to go back and watch the Schoolhouse Rock. I'm just a bill on Capitol and see if they can explain that to me. The sessions are 2 years long. So the Parity Act has got another year to go. And it's picking up more co-sponsors. It made it out of the original committee in the House that it was in. It already made it out of the first committee it was in the Senate. The next step for that is the full Senate. And now it's going to be at the Energy and Commerce Committee. It made it out of the Telecommunications and I think Electric Toasters Committee. So, you know,
as opposed to the non-electric toasters committee.
Well, yeah, fire. So you know, we're still in very much the contact your Congress people and let them know this exists and that you would like them to support it, become co-sponsors or whatever, especially if they're now in the Energy and Commerce Committee. So that's the place to go. I thought it was cool that, in Congress, they were talking about us. You don't hear that very often. And saying nice things.
Yeah, I was very encouraged by a lot of things that they did say, that they recognized just what we do. And then that was nice to hear.
Yeah, it was mostly boilerplate stuff, you know, the usual pat on the back. But I like that better than nothing.
Yeah, absolutely. Okay, give us a call on Skype, Net Ham Talk Live, or 812-NET-HAM-1 if you have a question for Gary. 812-638-4261. We have a few minutes left. And the amendments, I remember you talking about those a little bit, and yeah, those amendments scare me a little, but we'll see where it goes.
That's going on right now somewhere in the background, I think. I would like to talk to some of the guys at the league and see if they're in the middle of it. I hope that they are. What happened at the Communications and Technology Subcommittee hearing was people were recognizing that there is opposition. There's somewhat organized opposition from a group called the CAI, the Community Associations Institute. It's an association of homeowners associations. And they filed comments with the committee, so did the ARL. And in their filing, they had 7 specific points that they would like to see changed. Some of them fairly innocuous, some of them kind of deal breakers, but that's their opening gambit negotiating position. And I go through all that in the program, all parody all the time on hamradionow.tv. So if you missed that, stop by there. You had mentioned that you were watching the YouTube while you were driving, and I do have an audio version of the show. It's a little hard to get to. I'm a bad podcaster. I haven't taken advantage of all the tools. You immediately got on iTunes and are discoverable on the podcast apps and all that stuff. But you're on my Podcast Republic podcast app. And I haven't done that. I should. I've just been squirreling my audio versions away on my internet service provider's site, on the Ham Radio Now website. And that's not a good idea. That's not where media should live. So I've got to move it. I've had a fella offering to provide free hosting for my audio and video for over a year, and I haven't got around to doing that. I'm late. I'm lazy.
Well, one of the advantages to starting up the show is I took 2 months to get ready. So I had all the social media stuff set up. I had all the accounts set up. I had everything all set up in those 2 months ahead of time.
Yeah. I didn't know what any of that was.
That made it easy. Yeah. And the Spreaker thing just has all this stuff integrated, and so it makes it really easy. And honestly, I found out about it listening to an AM talk radio ad over the holidays, actually, and decided here's my chance. I've always wanted to do talk radio instead of just playing music, and here's your weather watch forecast for today. And
traffic on the H. Don't forget traffic on the
yes.
H.
Oh yes, and we're on your side.
Yep. Traffic and weather together.
Yeah, exactly. Traffic and weather together on the H. And I heard it, and I'm like, okay, here's the chance to do it, and it's really worked out pretty well.
So there's some latent hangups, but we're getting there. There's some latent wannabe broadcaster in you too, because I mean, you've done professional broadcasting in your life.
I did. It was part time, but it beat flipping burgers.
Yeah. So it
was a lot of fun.
Yeah. So we're fulfilling our childhood dreams here, where no one can tell us what to do.
Exactly. Exactly.
We run the show.
And one of the things, and I know you do a lot with repeaters, and I don't know if this has been your experience or not, but the experience we had with our repeater system was that we did the IDs the way we wanted to do them. We linked to whatever we wanted to do, and we did all that, and then we asked for support if you liked it. And it worked so much better than a club of 60 people all trying to figure out how to run the repeater.
By committee. Yeah, it's not too good. Yep.
Yeah, it just...
Well, that's what I say about my show and the support.
Kind of like this.
Yeah, well, that's what I say about my show and the support is you can make suggestions. I appreciate your support. I really do. But I'm going to do the show I want to do and come along for the ride. Or don't.
Absolutely. Well, thanks for coming along for the ride with us tonight. It's that time once again. My timer is telling me it's time to go.
So I have to
make my pun. Thanks for coming along.
I have to make my pun.
Yes.
That's a wrap.
Yes. Oh, you beat me to it. I was just getting ready to do it. In fact, Nick said, now you always did that in class. Why didn't you do that on the air? So,
well, you're a rap star.
So yes. Yes, that's it. That's a wrap. For this week's edition of Ham Talk Live, I'd like to thank my guest, Gary Pierce, KN4AQ, and all the callers and listeners out there in cyberspace. And I invite you back next Thursday night at 9 p.m. Eastern. My guest will be Tom Vincent, NY0V. And Tom recently took a trip to Myanmar or Burma, depending on your politics, to help some Boy Scouts earn their radio merit badge. And you'll hear about it right here on Ham Talk Live. So for now, with Gary Pierce saying over and out, this is Neil Rapp, WB9VPG, saying 7375, and may the good DX be yours.
Are we clear?
And we're clear. In fact, I ran over about 3 seconds.
Oh, my God. Well, you did my over and out, so I'm glad you did that. I stole your rap. You stole my over and out.
Yeah.
I got another comment on YouTube from someone saying, that's a bad radio procedure. Yeah. It's wrong. I've addressed this on several shows, beginning with like the second one I ever did on Ham Nation. Over means you can talk. Out means I'm gone. Over and out means you can talk. I won't be listening.
Yep. There you go.
What is 75?
That's God bless.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
As a fairly dyed in the wool heathen without any religious affiliation or particular belief, then I've never heard of that.
Yeah. It's kind of rare, and that's one of the reasons why I did it was, what's that?
Christian Kudnick had a long segment on his show this week, 100 Watts on a Wire, on 73s. He had to get into the 73s thing.
Yeah, I got to listen to that. I saw that was the topic. I want to hear that. Yeah,
those guys do great. Very fun to listen to because they're just bantering, just casual bantering. Nothing important.
Yeah.
It's a Seinfeld show. Your show about nothing.
Yeah.
But fun to listen to because they're so casual and they such good chemistry.
Yeah. Yeah. I really enjoy it. And that kind of inspired me to do this a little bit too. And just, all the,
well, don't worry,
all the stuff out there. So, but yeah, I'll get better at it. And
no, you're doing
fine. We figured
out
what the Skype thing was.
sorry about my lack of the proper mix minus on my first set of audios.
Oh, that's all right. I'm gonna have to edit anyway. So
I thought I had it all set up, but turns out I didn't.
Yeah, well, we'll keep doing it for a while and see what happens. It seems to be going over fairly well, I think. So.
Do you have any idea how many people are listening live versus downloads?
Yes. And stuff? Live was at 39 last week, and listeners was at 450.
Okay, that's a good start.
So, live needs to come up, but
yeah,
I don't know.
One of the things I'd mentioned in my review of your first show. Has anybody else reviewed it? Am I the only one that pays any attention?
I think you're the only one.
What's wrong with you people out there? Everybody just wants to work DX on 20 meters or talk on their repeater. They don't understand this stuff. What's wrong with you people? Get off the lawn, damn kids. So, I mean, as live is a conceit, you can get some calls and stuff. But if you're not, then, it just makes things more difficult, which is why I don't do live.
Yeah. And I really wanted to get out of the interview thing at some point and just take calls, but we may not have the people for it. So
it's, yeah, I
booked interviews through Dayton and then we'll see where it goes.
But. You're in the smallest of the small market radio size. And, when I worked in small market radio, we weren't a talk show trying to get people to call in, but every once in a while I'd run a contest. Somebody would give us something to give away, concert tickets or something. And I would say that, the third call, I couldn't go beyond third. I was never going to get that many calls. And, the first person calls up and I said, well,
congratulations, you're caller number three.
Well, if I'd have been smart, that's what I would have done. But the first time,
what I did.
Yeah. The first time was, number one, waiting for number three. There never was a number two and number three. So,
yeah.
I'd go on the air and say, still waiting for caller number three. If you were caller number one, call back. You got a pretty darn good chance of winning this thing. So,
we always picked a random number and then it was just like, okay, we're taking that one.
Yeah. We had one contest on in the morning that got a pretty steady stream of calls, but I was just, you know, I was your midday matinee idol.
Yeah, that's what I did, was mostly midday.
Yeah, so there were people listening because we sold ads and stuff, but they weren't used to the idea of calling the radio station for anything. I've got request calls every now and then.
Yeah, I got a lot of request calls, but it was a country station, so.
A little bit
corny. Which I still haven't quite figured out because I never have been able to appreciate country music very well. But
yeah, I almost went to work. Almost went to work for a country station when I was, after I got fired from the gig in Arizona, sent out demo tapes and resumes in television and in radio, looking for a next job. I kind of needed to go to work, and I got some offers back from both radio offers in the 15 to less than $20,000 a year range, and television in the 30, 40. When I worked in Chicago, I did better, but other markets don't pay like that. And I was aiming for Raleigh, and you know, so it was about double what the radio station was. And so I had the pretty much firm offers from both, and I thought, well, I guess I really need to live, so I'll need enough money to live on. So I picked video, but my heart has been in radio.
Yeah.
You can tell. And now I'm almost good enough to actually get there, and I'm too old.
Well, I keep, you know, we always make fun of the TV people that they can't mix audio, and I can tell you can mix audio. So,
yeah, well, because I started in radio. My first job in TV was doing an audio mixer, doing audio mixing. And, when I went freelance after 10 years of video editing here in Raleigh, when I went freelance, the guy that ran the audio studio in the same building where the video place was said, I want to hire you not full time, but as much freelance as I can get out of you, because you're the only video editor I've ever met who understands how to do audio. So
yeah,
that was pretty cool.
I can tell.
So I did that. And my professional work ever since then has been about 98% audio.
Yeah.
Well, and I like that better. It's more fun.
Yep. Absolutely.
But if I could do this, and one of the reasons why things go by so slowly in getting things cranked out is because I don't enjoy anything but this part. Talking into the mic, looking into the camera. This is what I like. And I, you know, there's no way I can afford a staff. Sorry, Nick. Any kind of a staff to do any of the other stuff for me. But I have to drag myself kicking and screaming to everything else except this part.
Me grading papers.
Yeah. Teaching. You like teaching.
If I can teach, I'm okay. But then I have to grade papers.
Well, the burden we all must bear.
Yeah. So
when I do a booth at a ham fest and do like six interviews segments in a row, I'm just so pumped. And then I realize how much editing I've got to get them online afterwards. So,
well, speaking of, do you need anything? Need me to say anything for your show here? Or
no, we've been recording right along. This is all part of the show. So. People will enjoy or not. Come along if you like it. So yes, you can do the sign off for me. Now you can do that official over and out one more time.
The official. Okay.
So I'm Gary Pierce. Wait a minute. I need to do the Arvin thing. Arvin's sitting back over my shoulder. If you enjoy Ham Radio Now, stop by hamradionow.tv, click the pig, join the Patreon, whatever works for you. If you get something out of the programs. So, thank you very much for those of you that have done that, and screw you, the folks that haven't. And now I'm Gary Pierce, KN4AQ.
And I'm Neil Rapp, WB9VPG.
Over.
Saying.
Oh, I do the over out. Part. Over.
And out.
We did it.